Have you ever had to grade footage and then when you chuck it into DaVinci Resolve, the white balance is completely off? In this video, I'm going to show you how to fix that. So we have this clip that you can clearly see is really bad, and I'm going to show you how to fix this in DaVinci. So the first thing we always do is we go CST, CST. I'll label this. This is the color space transform. CST. CST. I know this footage is Sony. I always work in DaVinci wide gamut. So I'm going to go color space transform. Input is Sony. It's going out to DaVinci. And then from DaVinci, I'm just going to option, push it over, swap. So it's going Sony going in. We're working in DaVinci. And from here, we want DaVinci to go to Rec 709, Gamma 2.4, because that's our deliverable. Wow. Now that is orange. Just to show you what my color management is like. DaVinci wide gamut. The output is Rec 709 2.4. So if you get footage like this, right? Now you're like, well, what do I do with this? Usually what you do is you can create a serial node and then you can start playing with the offset. So I'm going to use my panel. I'm going to start pulling the offset back and I'm going to play with this until I kind of find something that I like. But there's a better way to do this. The better way is you create a node before the CST and you use something called Chromatic Adaptation. You chuck that in your timeline. This changes the white balance way better than you can change the white balance with the offset. So the source, we don't know. But the target that we want is we're going to go daylight 5600. Now all you have to do is go through these presets and see what works. F2. Okay, F3 looks pretty good. So I'll remember F3. Okay, F4 is a bit colder. Look at the vector. F5. No, that's not right. F6. F7. F8. F9. 10. Still not liking that one. F12 is not bad at all. That looks pretty good. So it's between F12 and F3, isn't it? That's a bit too warm. F4 looks pretty good. Okay, so let's use F4. All of these Fs, by the way, it's fluorescent lighting. All of these are different types of presets. If this doesn't work for you and you can't find an image that you are kind of happy with, because I would actually go with this and then I would start grading. Start grading around it. The vector scope looks pretty good. I might do a bit of balance adjustments along the way, but this guy did all the heavy lifting. Now, let's say you go through these presets and you can't really find something to fix your footage. What you can also do is you go color temperature. This changes color temperature in a very mathematical type of way. If you know what your source is, sometimes we don't, but if it's tungsten, you can kind of bet it's 3200 and then you want to switch it to daylight. There you go. And if that doesn't feel right, you can start playing around with this. Just look at your vector scope until you're at a good point. And now you've recovered your footage and now you can grade away.